Hello again guys, I'm back, Kojiro from Gaming in Japan here, and in this video guys I will be showing you the battle against the Frozen Empress in the Cold Vein DLC called Frozen Empress. This is the second DLC. It's a short one like the first one, but the boss is really cool, so I wanted to show you the battle and explain a couple of things of how I played in this battle and some general advice of what you should do against this boss. I just want to warn you up front that I'm not using Queenslayer Blood Code or the Final Journey Gift because I find them boring, and I'm also on level 65 with this character. I'm using Artemis Blood Code with high dexterity and high dark gifts. I'm also using a Blazing Claw plus 10. It's a weapon that you get from one of the story bosses. I also play solo, obviously, because none of the elaborated strategies and advices that I can give you have any significant meaning when you are playing with an NPC. Like you probably already know if you have played the game, NPCs are really strong in this game and they can distract the boss really well and help you a lot in the battle by doing also a lot of damage. So here is how the boss battle looks like. Genuinely, like in a lot of other Souls games, you need to stay away from the frontal attacks and just try to evade the frontal attacks and get up behind or to the side in order to be able to do some damage while the boss is swiping up forward. Now, here is a couple of key things that you need to be on the lookout for. So, when the boss does this slight leaning forward animation, this means that she is going to jump backwards with a hitbox right below her. So, you can get hit by staying up close in that situation. So, always be on the lookout for this specific attack. And yeah, this one is what I meant. So when you're from a distance, you have to be on the lookout for a couple of very fast projectile type attacks and some like ground stomp attacks that have ice coming out right from the ground below you, and you're gonna get hit instantly if you try to heal in some of these instances. Now, this is another AoE attack that hits right below her, so you have to use this time to just get away. Now she's stunned. To get away, buff and heal up. Now, I'm also obviously using a lot of dark gifts in this battle alongside the general fast weapon. I'm also using the Blood Veil that allows me to do the fast evasion animation. Now, the pretty obvious thing that you're probably wondering about is what are the like levitating crystals doing in this battle. So I actually am not 100% sure about this. From what I saw and from what I can show you a little bit later in the battle, these crystals orbit around her, and from time to time the boss uses them to do some kind of a super massive AoE attacks, but they don't come out so often. You also, as you have probably seen by far, you can hit them, and if you hit them once, they fall on the ground, and from there you can kill them, which removes them from the battle for a little bit of time. But please keep in mind that in that time the boss is probably going to attack you. So you saw these AoE attacks there, right? So I'm guessing that the boss is using the crystals for that, but I'm not 100% sure. The reason that I'm using the Artemis Blood Code with a couple of cool gifts from Masamune is because with the blazing ricochet fireballs, I can use those attack to just hit the boss and probably hit some of the crystals at the same time. I also have the countermeasures gift, which allows me to leave a fireball in the place of the character when you do invasion just at the right time. So this can also be used to hit the crystals, although like I said, I really don't know what they are doing. Just I'm having this additional effect in some of the gifts to hit the crystals and just slow them with their actions, whatever they are, for a little bit. And yeah, that's the battle, guys. In the second phase, she's obviously in the second phase right now. She doesn't do like super complicated and new attacks. She has something like an ice beam right in front of her. But other than that, I really haven't seen anything more in particular. There is another jumping animation. So these are the EOE attacks. I almost died here. But yeah, the second form is not that hard. Just don't get greedy with the attacks and hit her whenever you have the chance. Evade with the normal or the fast evasion, and you'll be fine for the most part. Now, like I said, my character here is on level 65. I'm using this character because I'm training for a speedrun. From time to time, I don't play Code Vein every day or all day long. But I'm on 65 because at the battle with Bladebearer and the Cannoneer in the normal storyline, if I play so with the speedrun format, I'm probably going to be on level 65 there, so I'm not leveling up beyond this level. This is the normal new game cycle, and the difficulty for the boss with the settings that are available in the DLC bosses is on the default. So here you can see my blood veils, my blood code. This is the Artemis from Mia, and here are the gifts that I'm using. I'm also obviously using very heavy magic, also a flame weapon, the countermeasures, the blazing fireballs, and I also have blood sacrifice, which I never actually used in this battle. And on the passive side of the gifts, I have dexterity up for the one hand weapon damage. I also have Icor up with the more drain effect of the sword. In order to recover Icor, I have 30 Icor obviously with this blood code. And yeah, I'm basically using a dex mage for this battle, which is a little bit of a glass cannon. So here are a couple of the rewards that you are getting from defeating the boss. I find some of the rewards a little bit disappointing in terms of the ones that I'm only getting something like a tattoo for the customization, which honestly don't interest me that much. But yeah, the boss battles are very cool. The ones that require for you to do a no-hit run against the boss are awesome. Although, like I said, you don't really get that great of a rewards from there. You can get the special pipes, which are cool, but other than that, the boss is really cool, by the way. I like her somewhat on the par with the other boss, and here I wanted to show you the AoE attack that occurs, I think, with the boss using the crystals, but like I said, I'm not 100% sure. I have only played against her a couple of times. So this is the special attack. You saw that super powerful AoE, which covers a big part of the terrain, and you have to be careful. Here I just want to quickly show you how you can parry the boss. You can parry the normal swipes. I think both normal swipes are parryable. I haven't tried any of the other attacks, but my guess is that you can probably parry some other attacks from the boss, but the general idea is that you have to stay in front of her, and that's not really advisable. Now, the other thing that I wanted to mention is that if you're trying, maybe this attack also requires one of the crystals, I'm not 100% sure, but if you're trying to play with a heavier weapon, you're gonna have a harder time. Have the regular evasion, you're gonna have a harder time evading that particular attack with the ice aura around her, because your attack animations with the heavier weapons like the Zweihander are slower, and you also have a less stamina in situations like this. So you're probably gonna end up trading hits with her, which is, like with all bosses, not very advisable. So please be aware of that. And if you're playing with an NPC, I don't know what to tell you, like the boss gets very distracted by the NPC and you have more time destroying the crystals and doing stuff like that. But okay, yeah, this attack is very dangerous. If you're trying to heal from a distance, you're gonna get hit with the emerging ice from the ground. And yeah, this is the attack that you have to be careful about most of the times, because like if you land a couple of hits, she will end up either retreating with the back dash, with the back jump, I should rather say, or she's going to do the ice AoE, which does a hell of a lot more damage than the back jump. And when she's doing the other AoEs, you can see these purple and orange circles on the ground. This is the hit area of the AoE attacks, so be careful for them. And be careful for the jumps, because she can pretty much, if you're on around this level and this HP, she can probably one-shot you in some instances if you're something like a glass cannon, like my character is in this instance here. Weapons with flame damage and flame buffs obviously work very well, and ice protection also probably works, although I haven't really tried it. But yeah, it's pretty obvious from the boss that you're actually fighting, so I don't really need to explain that in details. By the way, I didn't show that here, but with the Blazing Claw, when you do the triangle attack that requires a little bit of eye core, you can do some more damage to this boss with the special attack, so you can use that to your advantage. Although probably in some cases you're going to be better off using the Hanemukuro as far as fast weapons are concerned, because Hanemukuro has a better range and genuinely like a faster attack speed and just better command list overall, in my personal opinion at least. Sometime in the future I'm probably going to try and show you a successful battle against this boss with my favorite poison build that also recovers I-Core, and I'm going to also try with heavier weapons, although they're not very advisable, because on one hand you have just in general less amount of I-Core with the heavy melee builds, and your attack animations are slower and you will consume more stamina for your hits, so this will probably turn out to be very difficult. But yeah, probably if you use parries and you recover your stamina from the parries with the passive gift, I forgot the name, but yeah, that probably can work out pretty well. So yeah, I love Cold Vein, I love Souls games like this, and I hope you like this video. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!